regular people.
A game show is where it's at.
Answering questions about irregular news stories.
You got him.
Huzzah!
Can they separate fact from fiction?
I'm going true.
False.
And go home with the prize?
Yay!
Play along at home as we have some fun with the wildest and wackiest news stories from around the country.
Holy wow.
Get on down!
On, wait,
what happened?
Wait, what happened? That's what we're trying to find out. I'm Frank Nicotero, a tourist here in Orlando, quizzing locals on real news stories with unreal outcomes. Let's see who's first. Hey, I'm here with my buddy Baxter right now, hanging out. And Baxter, I understand you have a lot of talents and hobbies. Well, list them off. Let me hear about them.
My friends call me the Bax of all trades.
Okay.
So I knit, I dance, stilt walk, DJ, I'm a technician. Not much I don't do.
Okay, what kind of dancing are we talking?
Like Disney dancing, kind of cartoon dancing.
Show me a Disney cartoon.
I mean, it's all big arms, like out here, like a Disney parade.
All right, I love it. All right, well, listen, we're gonna try to get you some cash. All right, this is how it works. I'm gonna ask you a series of questions based on real news stories with unreal outcomes. Everyone you get right, you get 25 bucks.
I'm all right with
that. Are you ready? Let's do it. Question number one coming at you.
Before he was a drug detection canine for illegal narcotics being transported through Kansas City area.
Chibi is a Missouri police dog who had a very exciting job, but due to some changes in the state's laws, Chibi's nose for no good wasn't needed anymore. So he was assigned to a different department in the sheriff's office, one where he can put his personality to work. True or false, the canine now works in public relations.
Ooh, Chibi. I'm gonna say true.
It is true. Way to go, you got 25 bucks. Chibi now spends most of his time visiting elementary schools, which puts lots of smiles on kids' faces. Chibi's drug-sniffing specialty was picking up the scent of marijuana, but with recreational marijuana now legal in Missouri, dogs like Chibi can no longer establish probable cause for searches, hence the new role. It's a good name, Chibi for a dog.
That's awesome. There's a story there.
Yeah, there's a story there. I have a dog named Scooby. Do you have any dogs?
I do not have any dogs.
If you had a dog, what would you name him?
Probably Michael after myself.
I thought you were Baxter.
Yeah, but I'm the one and only.
All right, Baxter, you got the first one right. You got 25 bucks.
Yep.
Let's double it to 50 on question number two. It's another true or false.
Honestly, I was like, is there money in there?
While no money was found in the woods behind an Iowa apartment complex, something that would have money started appearing over time. 11 of these in total. True or false, telephone booths have been mysteriously dumped behind the apartments.
Ooh. It sounds too good to not be true. I'm gonna say it's true.
I'm sorry, it's false.
Oh.
Yeah, it's actually ATMs with all the money removed. Police at last check were looking into the possibility of them being stolen from nearby, stolen ATMs. Did you ever steal anything, maybe as a kid, maybe a little something?
A few Skittles out of the candy jar.
What flavor? What are the best Skittles?
Ooh, red.
Correct answer is lemon, I'm sorry.
Ooh.
Thanks for playing the game, it's lemon. All right, Baxter, we're moving on to question three. It's another true or false. Let's try to get you to that $50, okay? Here we go.
I've known her ever since she's around 4 years old.
This 99-year-old Maryland man has known his 98-year-old wife a very long time. So long that they're celebrating a very special anniversary. True or false, the couple has been married for 80 years.
Ooh. I'm gonna say it's true.
It is true. Isn't that a sweet story? Imagine this. When he first fell head over heels for her in the late 1930s, the only places they could see each other were church and school. No FaceTime. Well, a lot has changed over the years. Their senses of humor have remained. Look how cute this couple is.
One thing I love about it, she's bossy.
I'm glad you said that.
I don't know if she grows on you.
All right, Baxter, you got 50 bucks. Question number four, here we go. This next question is a this or that.
Okay.
In Pennsylvania, a lot of intrigue over Ladybug's birthday.
I do know that some of my staff are playing sleuths and detectives trying to track down a further birth date for her.
Ladybug is a rescue dog, so no one knows her exact birthday. But why is finding it out raising so much interest? Do those who know Ladybug think she may be America's oldest dog, or do they think she may have an identical twin?
Ooh.
Yeah. I like how you always, ooh, each question.
You're hitting me with the good ones.
I know. Well, it's our staff does a great job.
I'm going to go with identical twin.
It's actually America's oldest dog. Ah, Baxter. Vets think she's 23 or 24 years old, which would in fact make her the world's oldest known living dog. This, of course, requires quite the birthday party.
Happy birthday to you.
We're here celebrating Ladybug Hughes's 23rd or 24th birthday.
Her family lovingly calls her a dumpster dog.
No matter how much we had her groomed, she'd look like she had crawled out of a dumpster.
Record holder or not.
Either way, you know, she's a miracle.
All right, Baxter, congratulations. You have won $50. Now, you can take this and leave, right? Go out with your wife, do something fun, do something nice, or you can take on the bonus question. If you get the bonus question right, I'll double your $50 to $100. But the bonus question is dangerous because if you miss it, you leave with nothing.
Ooh, okay.
So your choice is, you want to leave with $50 or do you want to go double or nothing for the $100? The decision is yours, my friend.
So $50 for a nice date?
Right.
Or I go for it and get praised for being competitive in my marriage.
So?
Yeah, let's go for
you're
it.
You're going for let's it. All for right, it. I love it. All right, let's do this. Good luck on the $100 bonus question.
Let's go.
All right, Baxter, for $100, here's your bonus question.
All right.
A California mom took to the streets in a cow costume for a very particular reason.
I really want our community to know that we got each other's back.
She's milking the attention from the suit in the hopes of keeping her neighborhood safe. But what is she doing while in costume? Is she serving as A volunteer for the neighborhood watch, B, a volunteer firefighter, or C, a volunteer crossing guard? Ooh. Dressed as a cow for $100.
I'm gonna have to say.
A California mom took to the streets in a cow costume for a very particular reason. Ooh. Dressed as a cow for $100.
I'm gonna have to say it's an attention getting for a crossing guard.
So if you're right, you'll have $100. And you said your wife's very competitive.
Yes.
You wanted to go home and let her know that you went for it and you won.
Yes.
If you come home with nothing, what happens?
I don't think you want to know that answer.
I don't. And I don't have to because she's a crossing guard. Congratulations, buddy. There you go. You got $100.
Very
you went double
cool.
or nothing. I love it. I love having winners on the show. And we learned a lot today, right? We saw canines are working in public relations. ATMs are being left behind in apartment complex. A couple celebrated their 80th wedding anniversary. And dogs can live to be 23 or 24. You got $100, Baxter.
That's awesome.
There you go. What are you going to do with it?
Hot date, man.
Hot date with
Let's
the wife.
Go. Yes.
Very nice. Say something nice to her. Tell her a nice message.
We are going out to Chewy's tonight, baby. Let's go.
Wait, what happened? I'm here with the lovely Tiffany. Tiffany, you're originally from?
Brooklyn, New York.
Brooklyn, New York. Now you live here in Florida. I mean, look at these palm trees behind us. You do not see those in Brooklyn.
Not at all.
And what about these geese right here? You don't see those
Definitely
in Brooklyn.
Definitely don't see those.
Those two geese have been eyeing me up for the past half hour. I think they're going to make a run at me. I'll protect you, though.
Okay, thank
all
you.
Right? Now, I understand you're really crafty. What's your proudest accomplishment that you've created?
Well, I could take extra-large t-shirts and make them into fitted dresses.
Oh, wow. I bet you that's very popular with you and your friends,
yes,
right?
Yes, definitely,
oh,
definitely.
Well, you know, here's what I want you to create today. Right answers that can win you money on this game show. Are you ready to do this?
I'm ready. Let's
All right.
go. Bring
Tiffany
it.
From Brooklyn. Here we go. Question number one.
They don't pay him any attention. I mean, they'll put their nose on him and check him out.
All right, Tiffany, here we go. Question one, true or false, for $25. The Mounted Patrol of the Kansas City Police Force welcomed a new addition to their stable. And this time, it wasn't a horse. True or false, the animal they welcomed was a chicken.
False.
You're saying false? What else do you think it could be?
A dog.
A dog, maybe? You know, actually, it was a chicken. It was a red rooster.
Oh, wow.
It's the
okay.
newest patrol officer at the stable. He was welcomed in after the sergeant saw he could hold his own with the horses and help fight off bugs. Good news, because he had lost his previous job with the conservation department as bait for the coyote traps. I guess Red is climbing the corporate ladder. Now, I'll tell you what, these geese, they might want to work at the stable. I'm going to go see if they want a job. Hey, guys, come here. Come here. Come on, you guys have been out of work since COVID. What's going on? All right, well, they don't want to work.
I thought it was great. I mean, I watched him build them and shape it.
One Massachusetts man took the age-old saying, when you come to the fork in the road, take it, and he ran with it. He built an 11-foot-tall statue that has become a local landmark. True or false, this statue is a giant spoon.
False.
It is false. It's a fork in the road. He built a fork.
Yeah.
There you go. You got $25. The landmark is quite literally a fork in the road. They even jazzed it up for the 4th of July by throwing a hot dog on top of it.
Oh.
What would they throw on top of it for Christmas, do you think, on the fork?
I'll say a pie.
A pie. You know what the correct answer is? A Christmas goose. Let's go get him right now. Come on. I'm still coming after you. Here comes question 3.
I mean, what she did is so amazing. And we just love her so much. And it's just so exciting to, like, actually be able to give her a huge hug and just say thank you in person.
An emotional first meeting for strangers as an Ohio nursing student meets the 3-year-old boy whose life she helped save. True or false, she did it by donating stem cells.
I'll say that's true.
It is true. Isn't that sweet? You're up to $50. Yeah, the young woman was a 10 out of 10 match for the little boy in Chicago with a rare blood cancer, and the rest is history.
10 hours of your life for the rest of somebody else's is insane. She changed our lives and she saved our little guy. So it's amazing.
Okay, this next question is a this or that. A South Carolina couple went viral after a moment from their wedding was caught on film.
It's a little crazy to think that our intimate moment has now been seen by so many people.
In the viral video, the bride pokes fun at how long it took for their big day to happen. Did she blow dust off her vows or put on a gray-haired wig?
I would say she put on a gray-haired wig. Yeah.
No, she actually blew dust off her vows. The dust was actually baby powder. The couple had been dating 15 years before tying the knot, so a little humor was in order.
So in the moment, I'm like, oh my God, she's about to say all these wonderful things about our relationship and how she vows to love me forever.
Yeah.
And when she pulls the paper out and I look down, I'm like, something is wrong with this paper. And I think I went through a range of emotions. Like,
like five different emotions.
Yeah, within that video. Like, oh my God, what is that? To, oh my God, I see what you did there.
Tiffany, congratulations. You have won $50. Now listen, you could take this $50 and leave, or you could try to answer the bonus question and double it to $100. But if you tackle the bonus question and miss it, you leave with nothing. So, question for you. Do you want to take $50 and walk, or go double or nothing for $100? Tiffany, congratulations. You have won $50. Now listen, you could take this $50 and leave, or you could try to answer the bonus question and double it to $100. But if you tackle the bonus question and miss it, you leave with nothing. So, question for you. Do you want to take $50 and walk, or go double or nothing for $100?
I'm going to take the 50.
Yes, I love it. I love it. You're a winner. Congratulations. You got $50. What would you do with that $50?
I'm going to take my kids out to eat.
See that? Say hi to your kids.
Hi, kids.
Look, at mom's bringing home $50. You were great, and we learned so much today, right? We saw that a rooster found a home at a police office stable. A man built a literal fork between two roads. A stranger saved a life by donating stem cells, and a bride has a sense of humor. Congratulations, Tiffany. You're leaving with $50. And what game show paid you?
Wait, what happened?
Boom! I'm here with my buddy Justin. Justin, what do you love about Orlando the most?
Ooh, there's always something to do in Orlando.
Right, like what are you gonna do this weekend?
I'm going to Universal.
Let me see you on a roller coaster. Do you scream, put your hands up?
It's literally, wee!
Not that loud? You don't? It's not much louder? So you keep your cool.
It's funnier that way.
It is funnier that way.
Everyone around me laughs.
All right, and I want everyone to fall in love with you on this show, so I want to help you win some money. Are you ready to do this?
I am.
I want you to be excited like you're on a roller coaster. Go. Yay! Question number 1, coming up with Justin.
When you're going out to the beach and unexpectedly there's this
Erosion caused by Tropical Storm Nicole unearthed quite the finding at Daytona Beach shores here in Florida. Buried under the sand was something at least 80 feet long that dates back to the 1800s. True or false, the storm erosion unearthed an old cargo jet. What do you think? You're thinking about it. What's going through your head?
I used to live in Daytona.
Okay.
I heard about something.
Okay.
However, I don't think it was a cargo jet.
Okay, so.
So I'm gonna say false.
And guess what? Whatever you heard, that's good because it is false.
Yay.
Nice job. You got to, oh, he's on the roller coaster again. You got $25. Of course, it couldn't have been an airplane in the 1800s. It was an old shipwreck. It's believed to be a merchant or cargo ship that possibly carried fruit, lumber, or manufactured goods. Guess what? You got $25.
Yes,
this
I love
is
it.
Good. I know. And we're going on to question two. It's another true or false. You feeling ready for it?
I'm ready.
Let's double the money to 50.
Let's do it.
It's the Justin Show right now. Let's do it.
First show we did here. The go up and all of a sudden you just hear a gasp from the crowd. You're like, oh, I never saw something like that.
In Albuquerque, a man lit up the night sky in a stunning way, forming shapes like a hot air balloon and the state bird, the Roadrunner. True or false, the man created these images using hundreds of drones.
True.
It is true. Way to go, Justin. You got $50. Nice. High five. Listen to this. The drone light show was part of the annual Balloon Fiesta. The drones create the images by flying in a predetermined flight pattern. Is that cool or what?
That is cool.
Now, what would you, like, if they were making a drone light show about you, what would the shapes be showing? This?
Yeah.
The moneymaker? Maybe you with your arms going up like this.
That'd be fun.
Like 100 drones of you going,
wee.
There you go. Hey, man, you're 2 for 2, $50.
I love it.
Let's go 3 for 3. Question 3 coming up.
I see him with the door open, and I watched him throw over like a teal package, and I told him, I think it's a trash bag. And he said, should I turn around? I said, well, yeah.
An Ohio couple was traveling home the day after Thanksgiving when they saw a driver throwing things out of his vehicle. When the couple stopped to inspect what was in the bag, what they found was surprising. True or false, the bag was full of packages out for delivery.
I feel like I've heard of this too. I want to say it's true, okay. But I also want to say it's not.
Okay, true or false, what do you think? We want to go 3 for 3, man.
True. Final answer.
It's true. You got it. Yay. You're 3 for 3. You're up to $75, man. Since the couple had the phone numbers and addresses on the packages, they took matters into their own hands. They drove to multiple towns to make sure the packages ended up in the right hands, delivering the packages themselves over several hours.
Wow.
Would you do that if you found packages? Would you take the why wouldn't you take?
Well, it's a lot of work.
I would want somebody else to do it.
I've always grown up to be kind-hearted, and I've always been kind-hearted, and I thought that was right to do.
Let's go for 100. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
Question 4. Okay, this next question is a this or that. In Massachusetts, Schubert the seal found his way from the ocean into a freshwater pond, a dangerous environment for a seal in cold weather that far north.
The fear was as temperatures get colder, that could ice over.
Eventually, authorities were able to rescue the seal. But how it went down is stunning. How was Schubert rescued? Did he hitch a ride on a kayak or turn himself in by waddling to a local police station?
I want it to be the police station answer.
I don't know. It's either this or that.
It's either this or that. I'm gonna go with the kayak.
The correct answer is he waddled to a police station. It's the one you wanted.
I know.
Listen, it's okay. You still got $75. Listen to this. He turned himself in by waddling to a local police station. It's the kind of thing you wouldn't believe unless you had video proof, which, Justin, fortunately, we do.
I thought everyone was joking until I actually watched the videos this morning. I never would have thought he made it this far. It's probably a good 300 yards from the pond to here.
From the police station surveillance cameras, you can see the 4-year-old gray seal waddling, hopping, and even scooting his way to the gate before trying to make a run for it once a Beverly police officer approached and alerted NOAA officials to help surround and safely load the seal into a kennel.
Any speculation of why he came here?
He knew it would be safe here.
All right, show me you as a seal waddling to a police station. You're not gonna do it? I'll do it with you on the count of 3. 1, 2, 3, go! 1, 2, okay. I'll do it with you, look. Justin, congratulations, you have won $75, but you have a decision to make right now. You could leave with $75 right now, okay? Or you could take on the bonus question. And if you get that right, I double it to $150. But if you miss that bonus question, you leave with nothing. So I ask you, do you want to leave with $75 or go for $150, double or nothing? It's up to you. What are you thinking?
Let's double it.
You're going for double?
Let's do it.
He's going for it. All right, Justin, let's do this. Let's get you that $150. A man in Maine stopped at an estate sale where he made an unintentional big ticket purchase.
Oh, wow, I accidentally found like something that's been missing for God knows how long.
Justin, when he spotted this item on sale for $75, he texted his former professor to verify the prized possession. So, what did he buy? Was it A, a lost medieval manuscript, B, a precious gem pendant, or C, a Renaissance painting? Think about it. What are you thinking out loud?
Wow, there's a professor involved.
Right.
So,
listen very.
Why would it be B?
Okay.
In my mind, because I would go to a jeweler.
Right.
Or
something
like that.
You're doing a little thinking here.
I want to say A.
The medieval manuscript.
I want to say that.
Okay. I'm going to tell you right now, it was not the pendant. It was either the painting or the manuscript.
Mm-hmm.
One of these is worth $150, the other one is worth nothing. You gave me the answer A, a medieval manuscript.
Mm-hmm.
The correct answer is a medieval manuscript!
Yay,
Justin, you just won $150!
Yeah. Thanks.
Look at that, $150. What are you gonna do with that?
Shopping.
He's gonna go shopping. What are you gonna buy?
A medieval
manuscript. You can get two of them because he only paid $75.
I know, that's right.
Listen, you were amazing. We had a great time today. We saw a shipwreck that was discovered in Florida, drones performing incredible night shows, a couple delivered packages that were thrown on the side of the road, and a seal turned himself over to police. Because you won $150, I think we both have to end the show as seals. Come on. I gave you $150. Here we go.
All right.
And we're down and we're going to crawl. But you got to bark like a seal. Say see you next time on Wait What Happened.
Bye.